no business. Came down. It's a problem. Shake it down. Good looking out, ho. As you do the fact. 2010. Big Snoop Dogg and the Gym. Now it's a wonderland.
This is a public service announcement sponsored by Just Blaze and the good folks who ride for the records.
Fellow Americans, it's with the utmost pride and sincerity that I present this recording as a living testament and recollection of history and making during our generation.
Allow me to reintroduce myself. My name is
We'd like to thank each and every one of you for coming out to support our illustrious potentate, Charles Fletcher Sally, as well as Galconda Temple number 24. Our duties are done for the evening. Once again, I thank you, I thank you, I thank you. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we will have Imperial Deputy of the Desert of New Jersey, Past Potentate Alan Hargrove, come forth to tend his duties.
Good evening, good evening. I didn't know you could step like that, Charles Fletcher Sally.
Hello.
You got no home anymore after all, anyway. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am Alan Hargrove, Deputy of the Desert of New Jersey. I would like to just say good evening. First of all, I want to say, Charles Fletcher Sally, you know how I feel about you. You've worked in my business, man. You've worked hard throughout the venues. And I want to say congratulations on the job as well as tonight. And I know you're going to continue to do the work that Noble's doing. And I will continue to call you a Sunday morning to make sure you wake up early and tired, Noble. Once again, thank you again. To the committee, to the ball committee, I'd like to thank everyone for all the minutes that you have given me. Y'all counted this weekend. I appreciate it. My wife appreciates it. I just want to say thanks. I just have one thing I want to do. I want to acknowledge all Desert Dive Bands. Would you please stand if you could? If you're here, all Desert Dive Bands, please stand. Thank you. At this time, I'd like to bring forth this evening a young lady who represents our deputy for the desert, Brenda Fitzgerald, daughter of Sylvia James, deputy for the wages of Galconda Court 60.
Hello, everyone. I know you're having a good time this evening. I'm representing the deputy for the desert as the deputy of the desert, and I will let the deputy know how wonderful this evening was. It was elegant, Cody, elegant. And I will let her know that. And I want to say, as far as I'm concerned, I do appreciate all of the amenities that was given to me this evening. Or today. And I want to let everyone know that we also have an Imperial officer here today, Gwendolyn Williams. She's the Imperial Auditor. We also have the Imperial Queen, daughter Kim Dove. I just want you to know that I wish you the best for the remainder of your administration because you're doing a wonderful job. You're working together with the daughters, and it's just fantastic because it shows that we are working together, and it's fantastic. Yes, it is phenomenal. Yes. From January to date, it's just togetherness. So I just wish you well for the remainder of your...
And finally, I'd like to just wish every one of you a safe travel home and make sure that Monday morning, when you wake up a little tired, that you know Galconda made sure they caused that fatigue. And at this time, I'd like to do my duties, and I'd like to bring up a young man who is leading this organization into unbelievable heights. Without further ado, I'd like to bring up our 42nd Imperial Potentate, Carl D. Parker of the Ancient Egyptian Arabic Order of Noble Mystics, North and South America in this jurisdiction. Please rise.
Thank you very much, sir. This is your day, sir. Oh, what a great day it is to be here in the presence of the Lord, and certainly to be here
from the desert of New Jersey. I bring you greetings as the 42nd Imperial Potentate of ancient Egyptian Arabic Order Noble's Mystic Shrine of both North and South America.
All right.
And its jurisdictions incorporate. Somebody once asked, what in the world is that? It simply means we have temples and courts in 47 states and 17 countries. Why only 47 states? Because some of y'all chose not to live in North Dakota, South Dakota, or Maine. You know, I have some imperial officers here with me. Most of them you already met. But we have our Imperial Oriental Guide, Tommy Hughes.
All right.
Our Imperial Second Ceremonial Master, Gary Sylvester. Our Imperial Captain of the Guard, Jawan Avery. Our Imperial Outer Guard, Dr. Terrell Gray. And you represent the deputy for the desert, ain't that something? Yeah, it scared you, huh? But you did well, yes. And we also have Gwendolyn Williams here, the orator from the Imperial Court. Charles, I don't want to miss your commands. If that's okay, we got Renee Hector. So we're glad to have you here. Where's the tough guy? Where is Daniel Norfleet? Dan, our Imperial Grievous of the Beatles is here. Yeah, kind of missed you there, sir. You know, it's always great to be here. You know, many years ago, I was in the military. I served at Loring Air Force Base Maine. I'm a retired command chief. And while I was at Loring Air Force Base, here I am strutting around there like a little banded rooster. I was looking for a hen. I want y'all to know I found one. Please meet my wife of 52 years, Sammy Parker. You know, to be here in this great jurisdiction, I would be remiss. Anytime you have the opportunity to have in your presence the most worshipful Grand Master of the most worshipful Prince Hall Grand Lodge, free and accepted Masons for the jurisdiction of New Jersey, none other than most worshipful Grand Master, Tisai Rasul Uwah.
He's over
there.
Good evening, everyone. I will be very, very brief because the night is late and we still have other people to talk. But I would like to congratulate my illustrious potentate, Charles Fletcher Sally. A lot of people don't know he is a phenomenal Mason. He is the type of Mason that the first Imperial Potentate, Isaac L.W. Holland, talked about. He's an active past master, he's a past commander in chief, a 33rd degree, and so on and so on. And he's one of the Grand Lodge, he does work for the Grand Lodge officers. This is just a testament to the work that he continuously does for the community. Congratulations.
Thank you, sir. You know, as always, when you have that Grand Master here, it's just so. Okay, we're certainly glad to have you in our presence, sir. But I need to also say, you know, you're a past potentate,
yes,
of Golconda.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Now, you know, I was walking around and I saw some of your peers out here. One of them, Eves Mignon.
Yes.
Most worshipful Grand Master, Massachusetts. Where he at, sir?
Oh,
there he is, all the way back against the wall. Also from the jurisdiction of Washington, D.C., we have the most worshipful Grand Master, Philip David. How you doing, sir? Glad to see you. I want to thank each and every one of you because you follow the brand of the Imperial Council. And that's our National Diabetes Initiative. We committed to the American Diabetes Association $1 million. I want you to know, over that 10-year time frame, you are currently at $925,000.
Wow.
We'll wrap that up this year. You ought to give yourself a hand. Because that says who you are and what you're about. And we're so proud of you in what you're doing. I also want to put on your mind, you need to designate what you're going to do this year for the next 10 years. Who are you going to support? Will it continue to be the American Diabetes Association? Personally, I would hope so, because we have a person that's working with them. Dr. Otis Kirksey out of Tallahassee, Florida, is so close to becoming a board member on the American Diabetes Association. We ought to make that happen, and I think we can. So kind of keep that on your mind. Somebody said, well, why don't you support St. Jude? We can support St. Jude, their diabetes program, because that's our brand, diabetes. Whatever we do, diabetes is first, and everything else comes later. Now, I got three items on the table that I gotta get done. Do y'all realize my 2 years is up in August? And it's been a blast. I've had such a wonderful time. But there's two other things that I need to get done. One of them is insurance. For every temple and court, stateside as well as internationally, we want to put in place a program that gives you the protection that will protect you. You know, I saw a lot of policies that didn't even have D&O. That's directors and officers coverage. And you are the leaders. That's what protects you in a lawsuit. It got to be in every policy. So we're working that. I have three bids right now. I understand we have somebody here that works in that area. And if she submit her proposal to the Imperial Council, to Ms. Lewis, we'll be glad to receive it. Now it goes four proposals. People fighting for our business. That's what it's all about. Amen. So we're looking forward to that. Think about that diabetes stuff, which way you want to go. This is your night, sir. I have preached enough. But it's certainly my pleasure to be in your midst this weekend. I want to thank you on behalf of all the DiBand members for the amenities, hospitality you have extended to us.
That's why I
stopped. Y'all know how to feed people. I've been eating ever since Thursday. My wife's going to run me to death when I get home. But I guess I got to run it off. So, Potentate Charles, it is my pleasure, sir, to be in your midst. And I yield my phone to you. Hoping you caught your breath.
I said the guys can get up and go.
Thank you, sir.
I was late. Some of you know me. I'm not a long-winded person. So I'm going to punish you all this. Tonight, I definitely will not be long-winded. I am overjoyed and overwhelmed. I am so overjoyed and overwhelmed that I could not put it to pen and paper, and that's why I'm standing here without a uncanned speech. My family, I'm gonna do them first because they always come first in my life after God. My family, can you stand up, family, please? I was born into a family that prides himself on love, peace, harmony, and charity. It's how I grew up from a little boy. My mother and father had 8 children. I am 7 of the 8. There are the remaining 4 of the 8. My oldest sister, Cheryl, 10 years my senior. My next sister, Stephanie, Not quite 10 years my senior, but my senior. My elder brother, I'm saving the best for last, y'all. I hate y'all to beat me up. My brother. My parents had 5 sons. He is the eldest son. I am the youngest son. The 3 brothers between us have passed on. So he left us to deal with our 3 sisters.
Wow.
And I don't know about my elder brother. I don't know how he's handling it. But sisters, I think I'm doing a good job, right? No? All right. Now, last but not least, as far as my siblings are concerned, is my baby sister. And she calls me her baby brother. Pamela. I have my first cousin, Sabrina Sally. I think my brother was there. And my first cousin, Wendora Sally. I have my cousin Bubba June. I have my eldest niece. I used to babysit her. Remember, my eldest sister is 10 years my senior. So she went on, got married, brought kids into the family. And she would bring them over for my father to watch them. And me being the youngest, I had to watch my youngest niece when my older sister would disappear. Presumably with her boyfriend. Not you, Cheryl. Not you, Cheryl. Okay, now, without further ado, and I said I wasn't going to be long, so I'm going to wrap it up. My sisters brought my brother-in-laws with them. A rare, rare occasion in the Sally family. My sisters come see me during the summer. And by the way, they're all from South Carolina. I'm going to ask them to show my niece and someone else I'm going to introduce in a minute. They come up to see me annually, sometimes 2 or 3 times. They never bring my brother-in-law.
Well.
I don't know if my brother-in-law's let it happen because they need a break. or they just say, go see your brother. My brother-in-law Jimmy. Now, this is the last story I'm going to tell, but it's an interesting story. My youngest sister brought that young man home to meet my father. She's in high school. Pam, I know you don't want me to tell the story, but it's a very touching story for me. She was in high school, and she brought him home to a family reunion to meet her dad. She could have been older than 15, 14, 15. Because I'm only a year and a couple of months older than her, but I remember this. And that young man, my brother-in-law, asked my father to marry my sister. She was still in high school. He wasn't afraid, and my father was a big guy. He was a mean guy because his wife died and he protected his kids. And he said, Mr. Sally, I want to marry your daughter. My father said to him, and I remember because I was standing right there. He said, do you love my daughter? He said, yes, and she graduates high school, I'm going to marry. My father said to this young man, you marry my daughter, you better be good to her, because if you don't, I'm going to lean on you like a ton of bricks. That man's been married to my sister almost 40 years. The bricks done turned to sand. Now, for my sister-in-law, Rita Sala, she was married to one of my brothers that passed away. I wouldn't say favorite because I love all of my family, but he's a good brother. And he died some years ago. She has remained a staple in the Sally family ever since. And I also remember when he brought you home to meet my father, but I won't tell that story. Who did I forget that I forget him? Oh, no, I didn't forget him. All right, my other brother-in-law, Maurice Antonio.
Big Mo.
That's Big Mo. And he married my sister that's just a year and some months older than I am. But I remember when he started dating my sister, they were still living in Brooklyn at that time. And I come over, my parents, both parents are deceased now at this time, so I come over. They just dated. She introduced me to this guy, this big guy, big girl.